نستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار عباد الله أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله اتقوا الله فقد فاز المتقون أما بعد respected brothers and sisters in iman the عنوان of our خطبة or موضوع of our خطبة is ماذا بعد رمضان what next after رمضان Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hijr which is chapter 15 ayah number 99 The last ayah in Surah Al-Hijr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَأَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينِ That continue worshipping your Lord. Be consistent in worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only in Ramadan, not only during Hajj, not only, but حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينِ Until when death comes to you. وَالْيَقِينِ فِي الْآيَةِ مَعْنَاهُ الْمَوْتِ Continue worshipping Allah. You worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before Ramadan. And in Ramadan you increase worshipping Allah. Increase worshipping Allah. Continue worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينِ Until when death comes to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says again in Surah Al-Hajj, ayah number 22. Surah Al-Hajj is Surah number 22, ayah number 77. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. This is a call from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O you who have believed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing all of us, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you who have believed. Irka'u wasjudu. وَعَبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, for you who believe, bow in worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Irka'u. وَسْجُدُوا Continue prostrating in worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ Continue worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ And do all good gracious deeds. Do good. If you do that, if you bow in worship, and you prostrate in worship, you perform your salah. If you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your words and action, if you do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves and is pleased with, and also if you continue doing good that you used to do in Ramadan, قرأت القرآن وعلمت القرآن You recited the Quran, you learned, you memorized. Yeah, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for istighfar. You are making a lot of dua for Ramadan. رجعت إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى تائبا. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for tawbah, dua, istighfar, salawat that you are performing on time, continue doing good. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ You visited the sick, you helped aitam, orphans, you helped masakin, you helped aramila, widows. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ Continue doing good, that if you do that, for sure you will succeed in dunya and akhirah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inviting us, even after Ramadan, that we should continue performing our salah, performing acts of ibadah, and also doing good gracious deeds for our success. We know that Al-Hadaf, min al-Ahdaf, was to attain piety, was to attain taqwa, was to achieve taqwa. That was Hadaf min Ahdaf Ramadan. Of the objectives, the main and the most important was Surah Al-Baqarah, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, kutiba alaykumus siyam, kama kutiba ala ladhina min qablikum, la'allakum tattaqun. Oh, you who believe, fasting has been prescribed on you, it has been made mandatory and a must, as it was prescribed on those before you. The main objective was la'allakum tattaqun, that for sure you will attain piety. سئل علي بن أبي طالب عن التقوى. علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه was asked, what is taqwa? فقال, he mentioned four things. The first one, قال التقوى هي الخوف من جليل أو من الجليل. It's a situation where you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You fear that if you transgress the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you commit a sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish you if you don't repent. But if you do good, precious deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised ajran azima. He has promised maghfirah, forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised mercy, rahmah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised great reward. You have to have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart. That is one sign of the fact that you have taqwa. The second one, al-amal bi-tanzeel. This is the situation whereby a Muslim continuously acts upon Quran. He follows Quran. Quran becomes his guidance. Not only Ramadan, qabla Ramadan, fi Ramadan, wa ba'da Ramadan. He continues making Quran to be his guidance. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qad taraktukum ma in tamassaktum bihi ma la tudillu. He said that I've left you with Quran and Sunnah. If you follow them, you will never go astray. Quran, yani kitabullah wa sunnati, he said. So when you follow Quran, you will never go astray. So when you follow Quran in your life, definitely you have a sign of taqwa. Aisha radiallahu anha su'ilat. He was asked, كيف كان خلق النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Can you describe the behaviors, manners, characteristics, ethics of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? فَقَالَتْ كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. The behaviors and manners and characteristics of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was Qur'an. In another narration, Aisha radiallahu anha asked the Sahabi, have you recited Qur'an from the beginning until the end? He said yes. He said that is how the behaviors, manners, characters of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were. If you want to know the characters of Rasul, you read the Quran. So reading Quran, understanding that that is how Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam behaved, and the fact that you apply it, you implement it in your life, that is the sign of taqwa. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam should be followed. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ahzab that indeed you Muslims have in the Messenger, in Rasulullah, a good example, role model. One of good examples that we should follow, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. That verily you Muhammad have attained the highest morals, the highest characters, the highest ethics, the highest best conducts. You Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has attained that. This is why we have to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَلِذَلِكَ عَلِي بِنْ أَبِي طَالِبْ رَضِ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ mentioned الْخَوْفُ مِنَ الْجَلِيمِ. Secondly, he mentioned الْعَمَلُ بِالْتَنْزِيلِ, implement the Quran. And the third one, he said وَالْقَنَاعَةُ بِالْقَلِيمِ, being satisfied, being contented with little that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given. Wallahi, there is no little. We call it little and we call it big, but that is not it. What is little? Money? You may not have it, but you are healthy. Subhanallah. What is it? Is it clothing? You may not have it, but you are safe. You have security. فَلِذَلِكَ whatever Allah has given you, be pleased with it. Say Alhamdulillah from your heart. Yani thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't complain. We do complain a lot. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal nas, in Surah Al-Fatih, Ya ayyuhal nas, wa man kan udhkuru ni'mat Allah alaykum. Remember the favors and blessings of Allah upon you. هل من خالد غير الله يرزقكم من السماء والأرض. Is there any creator other than Allah who provides you from the heavens and earth? لا إله إلا هو. There is no God except Allah. فأنا تؤفكون. How then are you deluded away from the truth? الرضا بقليل. Be pleased with what Allah has given you. Whatever you call small is not small. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you start counting the blessings of Allah upon you, blessings, أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ. Allah is reminding you of ni'am. Did we make for you two eyes? Allah does not only bless you with eyes, except that He gives you another ni'mah on top of your eyes. Ni'matul basar. That you can see, you have eyes that you can see. SubhanAllah. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ وَلِسَانًا. You have tongue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is increasing ni'mah upon this that you can talk. وَشَفَتَيْنِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is even mentioning your lips. Look at yourself. وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. You want to know the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You want to know the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at yourself. No machinery, no professor, no intellectual would have come up with a finger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created you, akhi wa ukhti fillah. So remember favors of Allah upon you and always be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number four, Ali ibn Abi Talib said, taqwa also means wal isti'daru li yawmir rahim. A Muslim must constantly, not only for Ramadan, not only when he goes for Hajj, a Muslim must constantly be prepared for a traveling day which starts from Mount until وقوف بين يدي الله يوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين. You must always prepare for death. You must always prepare to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ali radiallahu anhu mentioned that those are four signs of taqwa. Abu Dharr al-Ghifari radiallahu anhu reports hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And hadith is collected by Abu Isa, Imamuna al-Tirmidhi. أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال اتق الله حيث ما كنت. That fear Allah, be mindful of Allah, be conscious of Allah wherever you are. حيث ما كنت. Fear Allah in your house, fear Allah at work, fear Allah individually when there is nobody around you, fear Allah when there are people around you. اتق الله في المسجد. اتق الله عندما تسافر. اتق الله في بيتك. اتق الله في العمل. اتق الله حيث ما كنت. Fear Allah not only in Ramadan. Fear Allah wherever you are. In whatever you do, fear Allah in what comes from your mouth. Fear Allah in what you smell. Fear Allah in what you think. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in what you touch. Fear Allah where your leg takes you. Fear Allah. Fear Allah in what goes in your stomach. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on how you treat yourself, how you treat your wife and your kids, how you treat your husband and your kids, how you treat people in your community. اتق الله حيث ما كنت. وأتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحوها. In case you commit a sin, in case you slide, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إن الحسنات يذهبن السيئات. That verily good gracious deeds wipes away, erases evil deeds. So do not make evil deeds and sins to be your habit. Especially now that we are coming from Ramadan, where our sins were forgiven. Wallahi, every salah we performed, وَمَنْ قَامَ رَمَضَانَ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ. وَمَنْ صَامَ رَمَضَانَ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ. وَمَنْ قَامَ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ. Our qiyam was a means of our sins being forgiven. Our fasting was a means of our sins being forgiven. Every act of ibadah that we did in Ramadan became a means of our sins being forgiven. Do not contaminate these, akhi wa ukhti fillah. وَأَتْبِعِ سَيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ وَأَتْبِعِ سَيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا. Follow up any evil deed. We are weak. وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. We are all weak. We are bound to making mistakes. But do not make mistakes to be your habit. Do not be proud of making mistakes. Follow it up with good gracious deeds. تَمْحُهَا. When you do good gracious deeds, one good gracious deeds.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you ajr. At the same time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make that good deed to replace a bad deed that you did. Wa atbi'i, and follow up al-hasanata, good gracious deeds, with what? Wa atbi'i sayyi'ata al-hasanata tamhuha. Follow up any bad deed that you did with good deed. It will wipe it away, it will erase it. Wa khaliqin nasa bi khuluqin hasanin. Socialize with people, mingle with people, accompany people with the best manner. Ahbab, if Ramadan did not change your behaviors, fa anta khasir, you are a loser. If Ramadan did not help to change some of your evil and bad behaviors, if Ramadan did not, then something is wrong with you. Ramadan was meant to change some of our bad behaviors to good. Bad behaviors, right from your thoughts, how you think, your attitude, subhanAllah. Yani your life, back at home, oversleeping, overeating. Yani al-israf, wala tubadil tabdhira. There are people who make money and they are very, very extravagant. Ramadan should have taught you to change your behaviors. There are people who follow shaitan without knowing it's my money. I do whatever I want with it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul wala tubadhir tabdhira inna al-mubadhirina kanu ikhwana ash-shayatin wa kana ash-shaytanu li rabbihi kafura. Do not be extravagant. It's not your money. Al-malu malullah wa ma bikum min ni'matin fa min Allah. Allah says that whatever you have of ni'mah is not yours, it's from Allah. Do not be spendthrift. Watch your mouth. Did you change your mouth? Did you change how you see the ummah when we meet like this? Are you still seeing one Somali or one Arab, or are you still seeing one Pakistani or one Indian? Oh, Ramadan changed your mind that this is ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If Ramadan never helped to change your attitude, how you talk, how you approach people, fa anta khasir. Wa atbi'i sayyi'ata al-hasanata tamhuha wa khaliqin nasa bi khuluqin hasanin. Socialize, mix with people, live with people, your neighbors, live with Muslims in the masjid, kharij al-masjid, live with people in America because you are a representative of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They want to see Islam in you, how you talk, how you behave. After Ramadan, you are not going to go back to downtown to drink. You are not going to go back to boogie. You are not going to go back to do wrong things. You are not going to go back to commit zina. Then it means that your Ramadan was not accepted. So this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that wherever we are, wa khasatan ba'da Ramadan, we have to fear Allah in what we say, in what we do. Ahbab, ahbab Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is hadith narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, and this hadith is collected by Imam Ahmad, also Imam al-Tirmidhi and Imam Muslim. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam qala. He said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, there is a version of this, that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walked towards the minbar, and then Sahaba saw him saying Ameen. And then he climbed on the minbar, the first step, yani first stair, he said Ameen. He climbed to another level and he said Ameen, and Sahaba asked him, what is this that you are saying Ameen, Ameen for? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Jibril alayhi salam came to. And he told me the following, رغم أنف رجل ذكرت عنده فلم يصلي عليه. That a loser, a disgraced, humiliated, is a person in whose presence I am mentioned, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فلم يصلي علي. Then he keeps quiet that he does not send salawat upon him. He does not say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad ila akhir salawat. He does not say that. Rahima anfu rajul. That is a loser. He is humiliated. He is disgraced. If Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned and he cannot send salawat upon him. He said, then I said, Ameen. The second Ameen, he said, Rahima anfu rajul. Dakhala alayhi Ramadan. Thumma salafa. قبل أن يغفر له. Humiliated, disgraced. A loser is this person who Ramadan enters, finds him healthy. He's muqeem, he's resident. He's balig, he's aqil, he has his health, he's not sick. Then Ramadan starts until it ends without his sins being forgiven. such a loser. He took Ramadan for granted. He fasted because people were fasting. He never made extra efforts to reach taqwa. He took it for granted. He slept during daytime. He played cards and watched movies at night. He never, lam yastathmir fi Ramadan. He never ever invested in Ramadan. Yani Ramadan comes and goes, falam yughfar lahu. Then his sins are not forgiven. He said, I said, Amen. The third one, he said, Rahima Amfuragim. Disgraced. A loser. Humiliated this person who adraka indahu abawahu al-kibar. Yani Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him with parents. And they raise him until they get old. Then he realized that, oh, I have some education. I'm a doctor. I'm an engineer. This father is an old school. This father, the fact that he worked, he invested everything in you, he gets old, then you dump him in an old age home. You say, you know, when my father lives in my house, they are troublemaker. So he'd rather be there, we'll be visiting him. Ha, this is what you do. Then you take some flowers after every second month or after a year, you say, Dad, I love what you want to eat today. Shame on you. Shame on you. Many Muslims are doing that. I've seen with my eyes, if not in Colorado, wherever I was. I have seen people dumping their parents. Wallahi. Shame on you. It was very easy for your mom to finish in this place. They beg people to abort kids in this country. Now, they tell you, come. Abortion clinics are here. Your mother persevered. She carried you for 9 months. You do not know the pain of delivering a baby. Your mom cannot even finish telling you. They raised you. You did everything dirty on them. You did not have a single education. Wallahi, you are so ignorant. You are so ignorant. Ignorant of all. Mom and dad survived. Sometimes they could not eat, giving you food. Wallahi. There was no food sometimes. Now you're a doctor, you have some $20 in your pocket. Your mom and your parents is nothing in your face. Wallahi, there is no jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ridha Allah fi ridha al-walidain. The pleasure of Allah is connected to pleasure of parents. Wa sukhtullah fi sukht al-walidain. And anger of Allah is also connected to parents. You have, if you want jannah, go and bring your mother or your father home. Oh, my wife doesn't want my father at my house. Wallahi ta'ala. Oh, my husband said that he cannot live with my mom. Shame on you. Shame on you. Shame on you. My father, my wife, and my mom doesn't want my parents at all. Ha, no jannah. No jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you to see your old parents. Then they do not become a means. Falam yudkhilahu al-jannah. They do not become a means of you entering jannah. Shame. Humiliated, a loser. Hadith is in Sahih Muslim. My respected brothers, Ramadan came, Ramadan is gone. Mada ba'da Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa'abud rabbaka hatta ya'tiyaka al-yaqeen. Continue doing good. Do good to your family, do good to your parents. Do good to your sons, do good to your community. Be kind and generous, worship Allah. Connect to Allah, ask Allah for istighfar. Recite the Quran that you used to recite. Make dua as you used to make for Ramadan. Make istighfar, make tawbah. Read Quran. Qiyam al-layl should continue. Hatta ya'tiyaka al-yaqeen. Because Ramadan was a month of training. Ramadan was a month of training. Ramadan was a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you can even deprive yourself from mubahat, like food and drink, so that you can realize and ask yourself, lima khuliqtu? Ma huwa sababu wujudi? Why am I living? Why was I created? What is the main objective of my existence? If Ramadan never changed you, fa anta khasir, you are a big loser, you are a big loser. You do not know if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to collect you to another Ramadan. Time. Shaykh Hassan al-Basri, rahmatullah alayhi aw rahimahullah, says, Ya ibn Adam, innama anta ayyamun, fa idha dhahaba yawmuk, dhahaba ba'duk. That, O son of Adam, you are but days, you yourself. When a day passes, when Ramadan is gone, some of you is also gone. And so what is left in your life? If Ramadan, if you did not take advantage of Ramadan, what is left is today, not tomorrow. embark on worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because it's not too late. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in hadith collected by Imam al-Bukhari, and it is narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, la taqumu sa'a, that qiyamah will not occur, qiyamah will not stand, hatta yuqtada al-ilm, until when knowledge, this knowledge, the knowledge that we are taking for granted, knowledge of Quran, Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, knowledge of Islam will be lifted, it will be taken away. Ha, the knowledge will be taken away. Watakfura zalazil, qiyamah will not occur until earthquakes are rampant, are common. There are more and much earthquakes, as we have seen, if not in America, elsewhere, subhanAllah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam indicated, he told us the signs of qiyamah. And then he said, وَيَتَقَارَبَ الزَّمَانِ, and the time will converge. Time will pass quickly. There will be no barakah in our time. Haven't we seen that? Anyone who works in the office, tomorrow I'm going to do this, wallahi, morning until evening, you haven't completed your work. I'm going to do this with my family. I'm going to do this and that. Wallahi, I'm going to do this. A year comes and it goes. 2016, subhanAllah. Signs of Qiyam, you don't play with time. Allah is giving you an opportunity. Ba'da Ramadan, there is Hajj. Have you prepared yourself to perform Hajj or not? You are still saying, inshallah, you are making your own time. Where did you communicate with Allah that is going to leave you until next year? وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعْلَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ خِلْفَةً لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَيَّ الذَّكَّرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا. Allah made night to succeed daytime and day to succeed night. لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَيَّ الذَّكَّرَ. Do not take it for granted. Do not take it for granted. Allah says that when you see daytime coming and night coming, you have to be among those who remember Allah, or you have to be among those who are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing what pleases Allah, what Allah has commanded. Don't take it for granted. Maybe this is your last Ramadan. فَلِذَلِكَ كُنْبَاجُ your time. Time. And in another hadith, the Rasul said, فَتَكُونُ السَّنَا كَالشَّهَرُ. Then a year will be like a month. And a month will be like a week. A week will be like a day will be like an hour, and an hour will be like leaves of the tree eaten up by fire, yani burnt away by fire. What remains? We have seen that. We have seen our kids growing in front of us. We have seen, I'm 45, I'm 6 years, I'm 70, I'm 35 years. We have seen that. Do we remember Allah? Are we grateful enough? Are we thankful enough to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also saying, watadhahara al-fitan, tribulations and fitna will be apparent. Trials and tests will be none amongst us except that he has been tried. And look at the world around you. Then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, wayakfur al-harsh, then killing will be common, will be rampant. Killing will be common. وَالْهَرْتْ الْقَتْلُ الْقَتْلُ. We have seen, yani to the extent that somebody will kill his uncle, somebody will kill his neighbor, somebody will kill his own brother. It's happening, especially in the Islamic world. Look at what is happening. There are many reasons, yes, but look at how a Muslim is killing another Muslim. And then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, وَيَكْثُرَ فِيكُمُ الْمَالِ حَتَّى يَفِيدُ. Yani, wealth will be, you will have wealth in abundance to the extent that you will beg somebody to receive your zakah and he will say, I don't want it. Allah has given you a chance to pay some 5,000, 1,200. This is a chance, one of the signs of qiyamah. You will have a wealth, yani equivalent to a mountain of gold. Then you will go around begging people, can you receive? And they will not receive it. They will say, I'm fine. That door of sadaqah will be closed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This hadith is collected by Imam al-Bukhari. I want to conclude with the following hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asu'ila, Ayyun nasi khayr. Who is the best of mankind? Waqala, khayrun nas man tala umruhu wa hasuna amal. Who is the best? A person who is celebrating his birthday with 100 different colors of candles. I'm 50. Did you look back and say, does my a'mal matches my age or not? Allah, somebody is 80, somebody is 60, somebody is 50, then he's still a baby. A baby is not mature with Allah. Now, you may have gray hair, but how is your maturity with Allah? Man tala umruhu, you live longer, wa hasuna amaluhu, and your good ratio did also matches your age, then you are the best. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asu'ila, wa ayyu nasi shar, who is the worst of mankind? Qala man tala umruhu, is this person who has been given long life with Allah? Wa sa'a amaluhu. But subhanallah, yani his evil deeds outweighs his age. He's evil. 60 years, he's still in the club. 70 years, he's still drinking alcohol. He has not opened a new page. Saf ayyadida ma'allah. Ramadan comes and goes. He doesn't care. This person, yani 60, 70 years, 50 years, 40 years, what remains in your life? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a'mal ummati, that the age, the lifespan of my ummah is between 15 and 70. Yani, if you have more than that, that is extra time. That is bonus given to you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلِذَلِكَ you choose to be a good person or to be the worst of mankind. The last hadith, Ahbab, we need to keep the same spirit that we can't feel Ramadan. Sisters, you covered yourselves. Hijab is not optional. Hijab is not even sunnah. Hijab is fard. Many masajid, we don't talk about hijab because we're in America. Hijab is a must. It's a command from Allah. No, we're in America. I do whatever you want, exactly. But when you stand in front of Allah, or once you go to the grave, are you going to do what you want? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhan nabi, O Prophet, kulli azwaj, tell your wives, wa banatik, and your daughters, wa nisa'il mu'mineen, and all believing women, yudneena alayhinna min jalabibihin, yani they should cover themselves, right from their head until down. ذَلِكَ أَدْنَا أَنْ يُعْرَفْنَ فَلَا يُؤْذَيْنَ. That will convince, will make people to understand that they are women of respect and decent, and they will not be raped, they will not be annoyed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say that, you want to argue with it is your problem. It is your problem. America, Jordan, Makkah, Kenya, Somalia should not change your Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Allah wants you to die a Muslim. Suppose we died in Ramadan. Wallahi, inshallah, we were in a very good spirit of Iman, that inshallah, it would have been a good science of Jannah. But then how, if we die today, or maybe a few months after Ramadan? Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, narrated by Jabir radiallahu anhu, collected by Imam Muslim, and I will conclude with this. Anna Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam qal, yub'athu kullu abdin ala ma mata alayhi, yani ala ma mata fihi. Yub'athu kullu abdin ala ma mata fihi, that each and every person will be resurrected based on what he died. If Malakul Maut comes and you are dying, committing zina, what will happen? When Malakul Maut comes and you are drunkard, you are drunkard, you are driving a car, you die in accident, drunkard. When Malakul Maut comes, you are eating riba when you have money to save yourself from riba. When Malakul Maut comes, that you are not doing good to your family, you are not doing good to your kids. Kids, you don't respect your parents. What will happen if Malakul Maut comes in that situation? You will be resurrected as a drunkard. You will be resurrected as a zani. You will be resurrected as someone who commit. So make sure that you ask Allah for husnul khatim. Good end. Good end is very important. Wa abud rabbaka hatta ya'tiyaka al-yaqin.